Pakistan's incoming Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif has called on Washington to take seriously Islamabad's concerns about deadly drone strikes. Sharif, whose party won an unprecedented third term in Saturday's general elections, says the drone attacks are a challenge to Pakistan's sovereignty. Sharif says that he will raise the issue with U.S. officials. The U.S. claims that its drones target militants, but evidence on the ground indicates that civilians are the main victims. The drone strikes have sparked anti-U.S. sentiments across the country. Meanwhile, Sharif has pledged full support for planned U.S. troop withdrawal from Afghanistan by 2014. Well, let's switch over to Berkeley, California, joined by Mr. Saul Landau from the Institute for Policy Studies. Thank you so much for being with us. Looking at the situation now that the incoming Prime Minister Sharif is calling for a reevaluation of Washington's drone attacks in his country, do you think that it will make a difference and that he can actually get the United States to stop using drones in Pakistan?
Well, I don't know if the United States will heed the call of the new Pakistani prime minister. But, I mean, the drone strikes are literally murders that are carried out by the order of the president of the United States against people from abroad. There is no indictment of these people. There is no judicial process. It's simply a pattern where the president of the United States decides to murder certain people. And in the process of murdering one individual who has been targeted as a supposed terrorist, oftentimes other individuals are killed who are not even connected in any way, shape, or form with terrorist activities. All of these people have relatives when they are killed, and these relatives feel very indignant, as anybody would feel. And how would the United States feel if somebody carried out a drone strike against the people in Las Vegas, Nevada, who are ordering the drone strikes against other countries? I mean, I think this is a ridiculous imposition on the sovereignty of other nations, and it should be stopped. It's murder. It is not a valid form of warfare. And the United States is behaving in a very irrational and foolish manner. We are multiplying our own enemies this way.
Well, let's look at that, Mr. Landau. Let's look at what you've just said, multiplying our own enemies like that. Why do you think Washington is following this aggressive policy that many people, first of all, feel as if the United States do not look at them on the same level as far as humanity, because basically they cross the borders and go into all these different countries at will, killing whomever they want and not expecting to answer for it? So what has to be done to change this fact on the ground, as many people see this unfair practice by the United States in being able to do whatever it wants throughout the world?
Well, if I were a relative of one of the people killed, I would immediately file a lawsuit in the International Criminal Court against the President of the United States, the Secretary of Defense, and all the people operating the drones. And I would try to force them into a legal situation. I would sue them for millions of dollars for wrongful death actions. And I would make an international incident of this in the United Nations and in every other forum. And I think if several of the nations begin to do this, they may have some impact. I mean, what other nation would dare to try to do this? The empire of empires feels that it can do whatever it wants in the world and get away with it. And if the other nations let them get away with it, they will continue to do so.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being with us out of Berkeley, California, from the Institute of Policy Studies, Mr. Saul Landau.